You've probably used breakpoints before, but in this exercise, you're going to learn about more than just the normal breakpoint. You'll learn about two new types of breakpoint, the exception breakpoint and the symbolic breakpoint. And you'll learn how to share breakpoints between projects and with other team members.
In this course, you'll be using the project from the Practical Instruments course, but with a few bugs to find. Open the starter project for this lesson in Xcode, build and run, and boom, the app crashes. At this point, you've successfully completed the first step in our debugging framework. You've discovered a bug. This is a crucial first step. Before you go through the steps to fix a bug, even one that has been reported to you by someone else, first you need to make sure you understand the conditions that lead to the problem. This is also sometimes called duplicating the bug. Fortunately, this bug was very easy to duplicate. You just had to run the app. The first thing that you see is this angry pink line in Xcode, but not really on any relevant line. The app has been aborted by the system, leaving you at the declaration of app delegate. The second thing you see is in the console, just a bunch of lines of text. There's a lot there, and if you read through it, you can see that there was an uncaught exception with a reason for the exception and a call stack where it happened. You can use this information for the second step in our process, locate, but it's going to be hard to get any further than that, and there's an easier way that also helps with the later steps in the process. Click on the stop button to stop execution, and then switch to the breakpoint navigator. You don't have any breakpoints set, so the navigator is mostly empty, but down here at the very bottom is a plus button. Click that and you can create several different types of breakpoints. Even though the code for this app is in Swift, the exception is being thrown by UIKit code, so you want to create a breakpoint that breaks on Objective-C exceptions. Choose Exception Breakpoint, and a new breakpoint is created, and Xcode pops up the options dialog for it, but you're not going to change any of the default options, so just click outside it anywhere to close the dialog. Build and run again. This time, instead of crashing, exception pauses at the breakpoint you created. Now, at first, that may seem a little strange. You didn't create a breakpoint at this line. You created an exception breakpoint. But look at the call stack over here in the debug navigator. The top frame in the call stack says objc underscore exception underscore throw, which is where the breakpoint stopped. But Xcode is smart enough to know that you don't want to look at the UIKit code that threw the exception. You want to look where in your code led to that point. So without doing any additional work or hard thinking, you've accomplished the second step and located the source of the bug. You know now that there's some kind of problem inserting these rows. Now you need to inspect the data at this point to see if you can figure out what the problem is. Down here in the LLDB console, type this. And you can see that it's trying to insert 5 new rows. Now let's look at new total. And it shows 4. Well, this seems like probably a typical loop error. In the loop up here that creates the index paths array, replace the closed loop. Closed range indicator with a half open range indicator. You don't want to include the last value in the loop. That's the fix. Now all that's left is to confirm it. Build and run again, and confirm that the app launches without crashing. If you look at the breakpoint navigator, you'll see that the exception breakpoint you created is listed underneath the castigram heading. Most breakpoints that you create are pretty specific to a project, but this one could be useful in most of your projects. It would be nice if you didn't have to create the breakpoint again for each project. Right-click on the breakpoint and select Move Breakpoint To and User. Now this breakpoint is listed under the User heading. Now any project that you open will have the same breakpoint set. You can disable and enable it as needed, but you don't have to create it over and over. That allows you to share breakpoints across projects with just yourself. But even more useful, you can share breakpoints within the same project with other developers on the project. Set a new breakpoint here in this method, just anywhere. Then in the breakpoint navigator, right-click on the breakpoint and select Share Breakpoint. Xcode now stores the information about that breakpoint in a file that can be committed to Git and shared with the rest of the team.
It is often said that writing is all rewriting. Writing code is actually pretty much all debugging, so it's essential you learn good debugging skills. So keep coming back and checking out these videos, and if you found them useful, definitely hit that like button.